95%. This is the percentage of men and women who believe women can be great leaders. Good morning. I am Sandra Sancia Sultan. I'm a director with McKinsey and a leader of our Global Women Initiative.
Zero is the number of women CEOs in the top 40 companies in my country, France. Hello, I'm Charlotte Werner. I'm a junior partner at McKinsey and a woman of our Women Matter research.
It's a great pleasure to be here with you again this year at the Women's Forum to share the latest insights of our research on gender diversity. As many of you know, we, McKinsey, have been researching the topic of gender diversity for almost 7 years now on a global level. This year, we decided to take a new angle and focus on mindsets and behaviors. How did we do that? We surveyed 1,400 managers from all around the world, men and women, out of which 350 members of executive committees. We found some very interesting insights. Some of them are actually rather counterintuitive. But before we go there, let's take a fresh look at where we are today. So today, women are still underrepresented at the top of corporations. This is true both at the board level, even if there has been some improvement in few countries. But this is strikingly true at the executive committee level. Even in best-in-class countries like Sweden, there's only 21% of women in executive committees. And when you look at this list, the majority of this country is still struggling to get beyond 10% of women in the executive committee. So the photo does not look good. What about the recent evolution? I remember being on this stage in 2010, being pregnant with my fourth child, quite heavily pregnant, actually. And you can say the hormones or whatever, but I was at the time absolutely convinced we were on the verge of a very significant evolution. Well, this is not happening. Even a country like Germany, who has doubled its number of women, only has today 7% of women in its executive committee. And if you take a look at France and Italy, the situation is sadly stable there. And this is an issue for today, but this is also an issue for the future. Because as you can see, women are underrepresented at each step of the pyramid of talent. Yet, our research, our Women Matter research, has shown for more than 7 years that companies with better gender diversity also have in their top leadership, also have better performance. And not slightly better performance, significantly better performance. For those of you who were there yesterday night and also early this morning, thank you for those. My colleague Sandrine shared with you these numbers. The difference is almost 50% on average return on equity and almost 60% when it comes to average EBIT margin. So why? Why is change so slow to happen? Our 2012 study, it was a benchmark of more than 230 companies all over Europe, showed that a vast majority of these companies are taking actions, yet they don't see lots of results yet. If you look at the right-hand corner, the right bottom corner, actually, you see that 66% of companies are implementing many actions, yet they have less than 20% women when you take the N-1 and N-2. So obviously, it takes time for these measures to have impact. But last year, our research also showed that there were two reasons for this lack of impact. The first reason is that it is not enough to have actions. These actions also need to be well implemented. The second reason is that we discovered there were some issues in mindsets and corporate culture.
And that's why this year we focused our research on mindset and corporate culture. First big insight, women want to reach the top, but they are less confident than men to succeed. Women have ambitions, high ambitions, exactly the same ambition as men. I would like you to remember one number today. 79% of women from our panel have a desire to reach a top management position over the course of their career. This is exactly the same as men. And not only do they have ambition, they are also ready to do what it takes to achieve this ambition. Indeed, 61% of women are willing to sacrifice part of their personal life if this is what it takes to reach the top. And here again, it's very aligned with men. So just like men, women have ambitions. And just like men, they are ready to do what it takes. But there is one big difference. Women are less confident than men in their chance of success. And here, let's be very clear. We are not talking about self-confidence only. We are not talking about how much women believe in their individual skills. We are talking about women confidence to succeed in their current environment. And this is true at mid-level management and senior management. So what drives women confidence to succeed? Corporate culture matters. It actually matters twice as much as individual drivers. How did we get there? And please bear with me. It's a bit complicated, just like typical consultant stuff. We looked at women who have ambitions, and we split them into two groups. One group, women who are confident to succeed, and one group, women who are not confident to succeed. And we then compared their answer on a number of individual drivers and a number of collective drivers. What did we find? We found that on individual drivers, these two groups were pretty much the same. Same level of ambition, more or less. Same willingness to sacrifice part of their personal life, more or less. And same ability to promote themselves, more or less. But these two groups were really different in their perception of their current environment. For instance, in the way they perceive their company performance model, in the way they perceive the leadership style that is dominant in their company, and finally, in the way they perceive the compatibility of their company culture to gender diversity. So what does it mean? It means that corporate culture, collective drivers, matters much more than individual drivers.
So now the question is, what are the issues we need to address in this corporate culture? First, the level of engagement and support from men. And there we have some good news. Today, a vast majority of men believe that gender diversity in top leadership teams means better company performance. And we have seen a strong evolution in that level of support over the last years. Yet, when you dig deeper, you also see some much more contrasted news. Indeed, nearly 30% of men also are not aware of the difficulties for women in reaching the top positions. You could say, so what? There'll always be this kind of percentage. But this is a very big issue because these men who are not aware of the difficulties for women in reaching the top also feel that gender diversity measures are unfair. 66% of them, of those men who are not aware of difficulties for women, feel that gender diversity measures could be unfair. So the less aware men are, the less supportive. The more aware men will be, the more supportive.
The second issue with corporate culture is company performance model. Everybody agrees that a top management position means being available anytime, anywhere at work. But interestingly, everybody agrees, both men and women again, that in this context, it is more difficult for women to combine a family life, having children, with a top carrier. For instance, we ask our panel, is having children compatible with a top-level carrier for women? And we asked exactly the same question to men. And the answer is pretty striking. 62% of respondents say that it's compatible for women, compared to 80% for men. So it's more difficult for women. And working part-time doesn't help. Of course, it helps, as you know, having more women in corporation. But it doesn't help reaching the top, as all men and women from our research agree.
There is a third issue in corporate culture, and it has to do with the leadership styles that prevail in companies. So what's the issue there? Well, close to 40% of women we surveyed feel that they don't fit with the current model. So on that one, I'm going to ask you a question. It's early, so it's a way to make sure everybody's awake. How many in this room have experienced one day this feeling of not fitting in your company's leadership style? Can you please raise your hand? Seems to me even more than 40%, so I guess we are quite a number of having a struggle mastering these male codes. So, sorry. Now the question is, we've talked about three issues that we need to address in the corporate culture. First, men engagement. Second, company's performance model. And third, the leadership style. So now the question is, how to move that corporate culture? Our previous research showed that there is no silver bullet to make change happen in a company. Companies need to build a whole ecosystem of measures and sustain it over time. What do we mean by this ecosystem? It starts at the top with the CEO and and the top management committee commitment. It also includes development programs for women to master the dominant code and for them to develop as leaders. And then it is supported by a set of collective enablers, like KPIs, like HR policies, for example, to make sure that women are included in the promotion or succession round. So today, we reaffirm the importance of this ecosystem and of implementing the measures in this ecosystem. Yet, at the same time, we think we need to reinforce this ecosystem. And how? First, we think companies need to build inclusiveness. Let's engage men. Let's build awareness. Let's build men's support. Let's transform men into sponsors. Because second, women beyond mentors, women need sponsors. They need sponsors who advocate for them. They need sponsors who open doors. They need sponsors who put them proactively on the list that matters, be they promotion, succession. And third, companies need to think and to work on the performance model and the leadership model to make sure that they are more open to diversity and also to make sure that they are gender neutral. So, as a conclusion, we believe there is a need to foster a corporate culture that, as Michel Landel was saying yesterday on this stage, is more welcoming to diversity. And ultimately, what is good for women will be good for men and for corporations. Thank you for your attention. And please allow for a few minutes because we need to get the mics out. Thank you.